with all this conversation about energy and our climate crisis, what do you think is a realistic timeline for fusion to be a reality to help literally save the world?
Yeah, that's a big challenge. I'm first going to bring in a little bit of context about why we're, you know, rapidly accelerating the path to fusion energy now. And we have this unique time where we have advanced and manufacturing 3D printing is available. We have these large scale computers that we can actually use to model the whole machine. We never had that before. We just achieved that breakthrough of ignition in a lab. So we really have that deeper physics understanding of fusion. So it's like the convergence of all this technology now makes it a great time. We're looking forward to projecting a realistic timeline. So in the US, we're looking at building a fusion pilot plant that can demonstrate generating electricity in the mid 2030s. So that kind of would be the first step. All of this, of course, is dependent on, you know, good funding for this work so we can actually tackle some of the remaining challenges. So let's look at sustaining the conditions for fusion. So making the pulses long, so running our machines for longer, finding unique materials that can withstand these high heat temperatures I mentioned, and also this harsh fusion energy environment. And then all of the engineering challenges that go to actually taking that and generating electricity to go on the grid as well. So I'm really excited to tackle these engineering challenges, because what we've done before was really focus on the science. And now that we demonstrated break even, we're transitioning to the engineering challenges that we have to tackle.